Hello everyone, in this video we'll see about compatibility based system and history of Linux operating system. So compatibility based system is usually used, like compatibility based system is usually a system which provides protection for operating system. First type of compatibility based system is IDRA. IDRA is a compatibility based protection system that provides considerably flexibility. Like in IDRA, we have all the protections like read, write, execute protections, which was already provided in all the operating systems for all the files. But extra feature in IDRA is like user can define their own rights to protect their operating system. So IDRA subsystem is built on top of production kernel and many required production of its own components. A user of IDRA system would explicitly incorporate calls on these system producers into a code of a program, or would use a program translator that had been interfaced to the IDRA system. So based on the translation of the code of a program which is already written, or based on rewriting the code of IDRA, user can define their own set of rights for protecting its files. So second type of compatibility based system is Cambridge CAP system. So CAP system is not powerful as IDRA system, but it has two kinds of compatibilities. First one is data compatibility, which is like a ordinary compatibility. Like other Unix operating system, it only provides read, write, executable access rights for the users. Based on the read, write, execute access rights, the user can maintain or protect the protect their files. Second kind is like software compatibility, which protects the software components but not interrupted by microcode application programs. When executing the code by a body such as a producer, a force temporarily acquires a right to read or write the content of the software capability itself. So this is how CAP system production, data compatibility and software compatibility. Next one is history of Linux operating system. So we all know Linux operating system is a Unix based operating system, and Linux operating system is a open source. So first, Linux operating system was a small self-contained, like a single contained kernel, which is developed in 1991 in Linus Torvalds. So major design goals of Linux project is Unix compatibility. In early days, Linux development revolves large around the central OS kernel, but now like kernel manages all the system resources and interacts directly with the computer hardware. Linux kernel and like a Linux system is like the major difference between Linux kernel and Linux system is, in Linux kernel, original piece of software development such as scratch of Linux community, but in Linux system includes large number of components where Linux kernels can work under. Next one is Linux kernels versions, like when versions of Linux kernels based on the years and what was the support, like from the basic version to the till date version, what are the Linux versions released and what was it supported for. So first, Linux version 0.01 was released in 1991, which can run only on 80386 compatible Intel processor and PC hardware, which was supporting for extremely limited device drivers and file system. So second version is Linux 1.0, which was released in 1994, support for Unix standard networking protocols like TCP/IP, and which can also run as Ethernet, and which was supporting for more compatible device drivers. Third version is Linux 1.2, which was released in 1995. First PC only on Linux kernel, like Linux kernel PC, support for new PIC hardware bus architecture, and it also supports dynamically loadable and unloadable kernel modules. So the next, like third, fourth version of Linux operating system is Linux 2.0, which was released in 1996, supports multiple architectures and which supports symmetric multiprocessing. Next version is 2.2, which was released in 1999, which supports like network firewalls, routers, traffic management, etc. So improvements continued with release of Linux 2.4 and 2.6 with added file system supports preemptive kernels and 64 memory. Linux 3.0 was released in 2011, which supports virtualization, like improved version of virtualization, new page write back system, improvement in memory management system, and so on. So we all know Linux system is a part of Unix, like it's based on a Unix system. So Linux uses main tool development as a part of Berkeley BSD OS and X Windows system and free software funded by GNU projects. So main system libraries are created by GNU project. Linux system is maintained by many developers collaborating over the internet. A small group of individuals are responsible for maintaining the integrity of specific components, and Linux community is responsible for maintaining the file system hierarchy standards. This standard ensures compatibility across the various components. Software released under GLP may not be redistributed as a binary only product. So Linux license, coming to Linux license, it is an open software where it is available for public and in internet. So Linux kernel is distributed under GNU general public license. Linux is not public domain software, but public domain implies that authors have waived copyrights in the software. Linux is free software that people can copy it, modify it, and use it. There is a organization like a committee running on Linux operating system. Not only you can download and implement, like install your operating system, but you can also copy the code, modify it, and you can use it, and you can even give to the committee. If the modification is really good, it will be implemented. Any creating their own like modifications on Linux may not make a derived product properties. Software released under GLP may not be restricted by binary only product. So I hope you understood the topic. Thank you.